Yes.
Hi, everyone. Thank you all for coming. My name is Courtney Bicker, and this is my senior project presentation. My essential question for my project was, what are the steps necessary for collecting various food items to donate to the Lowe's Food Pantry? I wanted to collect and donate food to the Lowe's Food Pantry because I wanted to do a project that would benefit the community and not just the school itself. During my presentation, I'll be going over the reasons why I chose this project, my self-education, the successes and failures of my project, and my end result. I wanted my project to connect to the school's core values and beliefs. Throughout my project, I was challenged with myself and other people's shoes. I am fortunate enough to have food on my table every night, but I'm aware that so many people struggle to have the same, and I wanted to do as much as I could to help. I knew that anything I could get would be a big help, so by having other people donate to my project, it made them civic-minded individuals because they were motivated to donate and help the community. I chose this project because the process of collecting and donating food to the food pantry seemed very interesting and beneficial to me. It was interesting to me because I learned about how many people were struggling and in the need of food. Donating to the food pantry is also very beneficial to the community. I wanted to give back to my community, so I thought collecting and donating food would be perfect. I also don't want to be the only person giving back to the community, so I have people who donate food and leave them places for me to pick up, but others involved. Throughout the period of my project, I hope to get as many food donations as I could, help up the community by donating to the food pantry, learn many new things about the donation process, and make an impact on the community. And here are some pictures of some of the food I collected and maybe my announcement. My project started in January, and in January I needed to set up a date to put up posters around the school to get donations. In February, my goal was to have Mr. Finney make an announcement and advise you about my project and start collecting goods. In March, my goal was to double the amount of donations I already had and make one more announcement so that people didn't donate already could be running, they could still bring in food. My April goal was to collect any last donations and donate all the food to the food pantry. In May, my final goal was to finish my presentation and present it. This is an email from the food pantry. The steps to having a successful food drive are: 1, select the date and time of your food drive; 2, advertise your food drive; 3, set up a food drop-off point; and 4, collect all your donations to get them to the food pantry. These steps help me stay organized and motivated throughout my project. I use these steps as a checklist, which also help me and have a very successful project. World hunger is a serious problem occurring in the world right now. Millions of people each day are suffering and dying because they don't have enough food. Children are starving and having a difficult time growing because they aren't getting enough food to help them develop. Food donations are always important because they could always save a life. Going off my previous slide, food pantries are very important to the community and they're in serious need of donations right now because of COVID-19. Because of the pandemic, millions of people have lost their jobs since the world is basically shut down. Without any income, people and families can't afford to buy groceries. Because of this, so many people are going to the food pantry more than they used to. I really wanted to donate to the food pantry because I know that people are relying on these pantries for food. But their supply of food is low, and they are in serious need of it right now. So I thought any donations I could give would be a big help. And here's another walk into the church. There are lots of benefits volunteering. It gives people positive self-image because they're doing something good, so it makes you feel good. It also helps you create new relationships with people, and you learn many new skills that you didn't learn. Even though my project is completed, I'm still committed to helping the food pantry as best I can. A lot of people have asked me these 3 common questions. First one is, what is the best time of year to donate? Honestly, like any time of year is like the best time to donate because they're always looking for donations. But people think it's like the holidays, but around the summertime is a big one because kids aren't getting food from the school anymore. The second most asked question was, can I donate money? Yeah, you can donate money because the volunteers will just go out and buy food with that money. The third most common asked question is, what are the items that are most needed? The items that are most needed are canned food, box food, cereal, and detergent. Although they accept items that need to be refrigerated, they don't need space right now, so they prefer more like box items and stuff that people want on shelves. For my final product, I had 2 boxes and 7 paper bags filled with food donations. I then took this food to the Lowe's Food Pantry at the Church of Christ. Even though my goal was to had many successes and failures. I raised a lot of food, I've been volunteering, donating, and I helped as many people as I could. The only thing I would say I had for how long it took for people to start to donate, and also the church is only open certain days and certain hours, like throughout the week and month. So it was hard to find like a time to go there and drop it off, but eventually like I found a time to bring it there. But even with the announcements and signs around the school, it took a while for the donation boxes to fill, but eventually more people started to donate. Throughout this project, I learned a lot of things. I learned more about time management and how it's important to have deadlines so that people know when they have to donate the food by, and so I can donate the food on time. I also learned the benefits from volunteering and donating. I wasn't only making an impact on the community, but it also helped my personal growth. I realized that my volunteering and donating made me feel happy and that what I was doing could change a life. And finally, I learned the importance of food pantries and that the food I donated could change our personal and family's life. My advice for rising seniors is to pick a project that really interests you and that you have fun with. You'll be spending a lot of time on your project, so you want to do something that excites you every time you work on it. I emphasize spending a lot of time on your project because you want it to be the best you can. With all the time and effort you put into your desired project, you want to make sure it's you are happy and satisfied with the result.
Thank you, Richard.
Any donations we have there? For my thank you slide, I want to thank Mr. Bigelow for all the help he did. Ideas on how to get donations. I also want to thank everyone for helping donate to my project. I collected so much food and had a successful project because of all the help from them.